When I paint, I like to understand my subject as much as possible. In this case, I was painting a Ferrari. I've not had much experience with Ferraris, and I wanted to connect with, understand, and learn about Ferrari. I had to do that in order to do this painting. In order to help me do that, I did a lot of research and came up with this mind map about things related to Ferrari. Learning about the history of Ferrari was fascinating. I saw that Enzo Ferrari had a son who died, and you can see it in his face in before and after pictures. He was an amazing man. There is a decorated World War I pilot from Italy, Francesco Baracca, I hope I said that right, who had this personal emblem on his plane. His parents allowed Ferrari to use the symbol, which became the Ferrari logo. This is a mind map that I made to help me understand and feel more connected with the Ferrari legend. This was done with MindJet. This is one of the earlier stages of the painting. I have finished the background. I do that first so that I can paint the car on top of it and I don't have to try to go back and fix any of the background and get that done. So this is an early stage of the car. I lay out the basic forms first in one color. You can see here we have orange and then blues down here. This is actually a very hard way to paint in a way because you end up with, well, I don't like how it looks for the first, for most of the painting, but it lays out a nice understructure of form. So it's pretty much always the way I paint. It takes a lot longer, but it's worth it in the end. More painful, longer, but worth it. And so here's the next, another stage. This is what my desk was looking like at one point. Don't look at the water. It was before I changed it. So this is on my desk. I like to use this as an easel. And there are these little jars of paint. I like to use them for mixed paint. And this here, this tape is great for making clean, curvy lines. Here's the next spot. It's just moving further, adding more color, building up color. You can see there's some colors coming into the shadows here. Going a little bit further, adding some more color still. Even more, getting the little horse in his helmet. This is really tiny in the real world. This is the final. So there is some pretty cool little details in here. Kind of fun. See how the paint is. Alright, so now we're going to come up to this point where I am beginning the UV light painting. So this is the second painting on top of the first painting, and you can, to a certain degree, you can see the car underneath them. Here's the headlights. There's a tire. So this painting, this kind of paint, takes a long time to build up. So I've started to build up their bodies and details and things like that. Here, going a little bit further, there's more layers of paint on the face, and then I'm beginning the glow-in-the-dark painting right here. This is a family member on a go-kart. And here is actually the final version of the painting in black light or fluorescent light, and there are all the logos here. The horse. It's tough to get a great picture of this part of the painting just because it's so it's just a, you know, I'm taking it in a black light. So then here we go. This is to show I have the regular light on and I have a UV light on so that you can see what's happening. But in only regular light, this is what you see. It's basically like the family is totally invisible. So this is the final version of the third painting, and this is glowing in the dark. We have the Ferrari symbol right here, and the family name, and I snuck the word love in there, and the go-kart glowing. So this is all glowing in the dark. And subtly over here, you can see there's the word family. On a final note, this painting took about 100 hours from start to finish. And one person's experience with this was, the race car is amazing. It seems so alive and not an inanimate object. I cannot recall ever experiencing a race car picture with that feel. Thank you.